score 11 years of grade 5, also from Yumin Primary School.
For this lesson, we'll still be at
Calculus Chapter 7, Double and Triple Integrals. So, last lesson, we have done this question, right?
Yes.
And last lesson was the first method, yep. The polar coordinates.
That was what I did, right?
Okay, then in this lesson, we'll use another method.
Which is the second method, right?
Yes, a Cartesian coordinates.
Yep, but instead, what will we use? Substitution, right?
Yes, trigonometric substitution.
Yep. And you want X first or Y first?
I would rather use Y first.
Okay.
Okay, so for this, trigonometric substitution. Do you know what this integral region is? And I'll read out this question while you draw that, okay? So this double integral, the integral region is D, that is bounded by x squared plus y squared equals 2x, and the x is bigger or equals to 1. So here, the integrand 1 over bracket x squared plus y squared bracket squared then is dx dy. Okay. So right now you're drawing that out, right?
Yep.
So for this, in the last lesson, we've already figured out what kind of graph it is. That is a circle. But this circle is, the center is at x equals 1. X is 1 and when y is 0. So we figured that out by using the completing square. So what is that point? That is the 1. Okay, so which region is it?
I already cut it into two, so you guess which one?
Well, I'm not sure.
So actually, let me give a clue. I haven't drawn it yet.
Well, is it that whole semicircle?
Yeah.
How did you get that? Why is it a whole semicircle instead of a whole circle?
Is it because...
You know why?
Yeah.
Yes.
Bigger equals to 1.
X is bigger equals to 1. So that part is the x bigger or equal to 1.
Yeah. And then we get that here's 1, here's negative 1.
Okay, so that means for this, so first according to y.
Okay. We definitely need to use substitution, and now you might got the wrong answer.
Now, for this, but what is their boundary? And also just now when you said we must use substitution, it is actually not a must, because we have different methods. But what they need to be careful of is which one first.
Yep, because that sometimes if you choose x first, wrong, sometimes you choose x first, correct. So it just depends on the question.
Yes.
Okay, so now, you're asking for y, right?
Y's range.
about that, okay?
Okay. How did you get that?
Because that, look at this.
Write it out first.
So, for example, you look like that, and over there is. Okay, so look at this, okay? Pay attention. So here. After that, y square will still be here. But because that you are finding y, so that like you will shift this x square behind, but because they are going to become a negative, so we don't want to make it too complicated to write. So then we just put this part here. Okay?
Yup.
But this is a square. We want this. We just want the x. I mean a y. We don't want the y square, right?
Yeah.
So we need to square root it. So this whole thing also need to square root. So that's how
I think you made a little bit of mistake.
Wait, later I'll say, because that I haven't read finished. So if you notice my mistake, good. So first, what about for this part? Let me just
correct it first.
Is something like this, okay?
Because plus and minus, both your squares are still plus. The positive, yes, right?
Because whatever square is a plus, but itself might not be a positive. Because that anything square is all a positive, even though it's a negative square. But if you square root the square, right? We will get sometimes a negative, sometimes a positive. So we are not sure. So we need a plus minus.
Yes.
So in this case, this is the lower semicircle. I mean the lower quarter circle and the upper quarter circle for the part semicircle that we are finding, right?
Yeah.
Like this?
Sure. Okay. So then, at this part. So are you saying that this is the range, the boundary?
Yes.
Then how about for x?
For x, easy. Look, from here, right?
Yeah.
To here. So what to do?
One to do. One, two, two.
No, one, all the way to two.
Okay, so next, what do we need to use? What do we need?
Shall we use something?
A formula.
Yes.
What is that? Can you prove that out?
Okay, so you want me to write it away? Okay. Okay, so let's just first write it here, okay?
I don't think this space is enough. Ready? Okay, so what you need to prove is...
Write it out first.
This, find out what is it equal to.
So I'll prove the whole thing, right?
Yes.
There's a problem. I can't solve it. Then, you know why I can't solve it?
You can't straight away use the basic formulas.
So what should I do?
You should try something.
Factorization?
Obviously no.
Binomial expansion?
That's dumb.
Partial fraction?
Why partial fraction?
Means that expand first in partial fraction.
Why would you want that?
Oh, so it is sub?
The clue is somewhere.
That.
Yes, and that is a substitution. do I inverse?
Wait, you don't know how I do this. If the like
Suddenly a bracket.
I got one did.
Because here you end, right? So what if I ask?
What the range?
No, I want to ask. Can you change it into cotangent?
Yes.
Okay, you got this. So how about that range?
That's why I asked you just now.
But I don't get it. So just write the range.
Can I write the range? Then look at the question first. Why would you even write the range if it's an indefinite integral?
Oh yeah.
Because that is an indefinite integral, so you need to plug the C. So that means
I don't have range.
Not you. It's this question. Not you. Of course, you don't have a ring. Can you write down the formula, please?
For what?
Wait. So, something will remind you of that thing. Have you think about it?
Have what?
Do you got the idea? Do you got the idea?
Walk it first.
That means the trick, right?
There it is.
It's a trick. So something like this, right?
Yeah.
Focus.
Yup, for just kidding. Suddenly no square. Where had that square gone?
It gone for a vacation. And then you didn't find another mistake. Why no theta's here?
And why is this a Y?
Why?
What just happened? Why? Okay, yeah, that's much better. That's an AQ.
Yes, because that here still got a square then.
So next, that means you have the 1 plus tangent square theta square, right?
Wait.
Yes, so any problem?
Oh, I know why.
Oh, yeah. Oh, because it is here, right?
Yup, if not, what will you simplify even? Simplify nothing? I just found out the mistake.
Why is there d theta d over d theta?
Yeah. Guess what will I do?
I think with my mind, simplify.
Nah, after that.
Because secant is the 1 over cosine, so you put that cosine in the numerator. So that means the denominator will be a 1. And done.
Is that right?
No. Cosine square.
Oh. Guess what I do now? Guess what I do now, okay?
Double angle.
After double angle? I mean double angle. I said after double angle, I already
separation.
Yes. Can you write it down faster?
So I have this, right?
Yes.
So now you're integrating it.
How should I integrate this?
Put a 2 here, then you can integrate.
Okay. Did this remind you of something? Did this remind you of something? Write it down, please.
Another double angle.
Yes, and did this remind you of something? But you don't need to write it down.
Subbing it back.
Yes. That's why. Haha. You didn't find a mistake. I didn't even write the inverse just now. Okay, so. Let me see what trick I want to use.
Why are you using tricks?
To blow your mind. Guess why didn't I write the half?
You use that, of course.
Okay, so there will be a trick.
Let me ask you, why isn't there a C?
So here. I will use a trick to blow your mind.
How?
But first, you
can't blow my mind.
But first, you can say it out after I write finish. Then you can say it out. What are you doing?
Preparing.
Wait, no, now no me.
Done yet?
Nope. Stop. Why are you writing even?
So that is what, how you use Pythagoras theorem, right?
Yes.
Sine and cosine. Right?
Yep.
So for this.
Yeah. Since it's an operable addition, we could draw out the triangle, and since you already
And it's also a right angle triangle.
Must. Okay. It's a must. And here, the y, because it's the operable addition, right?
Yeah.
So that means this y on top is, good thing that here is the inverse, because that, what are you doing?
Yeah.
It, good thing is the inverse, because that here will be a whole number, means that there won't be any. Could I use degrees?
Why would you want to use degrees?
Actually, in calculus, you cannot use degrees, you should just use radian. So that means there will no pi's anymore. So here, we'll know that this y is the oppo. So y here, oppo, and a will be the adjacent. Then after that, we'll use the Pythagorean theorem. Okay? Okay?
Okay.
So now you could continue with the question, okay?
So that means I'll just use this
answer.
But just that I'll exclude the C.
Of course you exclude the C. If you want to use it, like this was the boundary, you must have the ring. If you don't have the boundaries, you don't need those.
So I'll just write this as the x squared plus y squared.
Okay.
Because we follow the alphabetical order.
No. It's not order, it's order.
Okay. Oops, I accidentally said order.
Okay, so. Great, you caught a trick. Oi, wrong. My friend. So, except for let me just say that your idea is not that good. You know why? Even though you are correct, means that you put it here, but the formula usually put it here. So, best if you put it here so that we won't start that. So at last you won't.
But this way you'll know that after you separate them, you can just put this in.
I know. It's correct.
So can I erase this?
Yes, of course, because you already used this.
So for this, in the next step. Did you wonder where did my half go?
Bye-bye.
Why?
Because then you combine.
Combine the two terms, is it?
Yeah.
So y squared, when you put those in, you have a 2x and this minus an x squared.
Okay.
So it's like this, right?
Yes.
Then in the next, you can separate them, right?
Yes.
So, meanwhile, this part, we can cancel these two, simplify.
Yep.
So, is it like this? Is it?
Yes.
Then we can put this x inside and this x cubed inside. Meanwhile, x, take one here, x squared, put it in. Right?
Yeah.
Like this?
Yeah.
So while I'm writing, can you explain?
So here now you put the x into the square root and you split the fraction. After that, and you will put the x cubed in, and after you put the x cubed in.
So at this part, can I just put here a 2?
Okay.
So that we can solve this.
Okay.
So it becomes like this, right?
Yes, if no, we can't solve
but
it.
But why? Why when we just add a 2 there, we can solve it? Why?
Is it because here?
Okay, that is a 2 over x, so what? What's the matter? Okay, so we can just think this as a square root of y minus 1 dy. We can think it as like that, right?
Okay.
Okay. So that makes the integration easier.
Okay.
So is it like this?
Yes.
So this, wait, how did I get this? You know how?
Because then you integrate, I mean by integral by parts.
Yes, correct, integral by parts. Like this, is it right?
Yes.
So we still have one more term here, right?
Yep.
Here is a minus 1/4 times, because you need a half at one reciprocal. That is a 2/3. And
okay.
Here is a square root 2/(x-1), and this thing's cube. Then start from 1 all the way to 2, right?
Okay.
So next, for this, that part, 1 can sub in and 2 also, right? But if you sub in 2, you'll realize inverse tangent 0. That is a 0, right?
Yes.
So we don't have. Then it's a positive half times pi over 4. Because the pi over 4 came from inverse tangent 1. That makes a pi over 8. Am I right?
Yes.
So this will plus. But what? What does it plus? Do you know what?
What?
So we can just differentiate for that inverse tangent, that whole thing, to come out. So for this, we'll need the chain rule.
Yep.
So first, let's look at the inverse tangent. That makes this, right?
Yes.
Then we'll look at the square root 2 over x minus 1. Is it like this?
Okay.
So then we have minus 1 over 6 and pretty much plus, right?
Yes.
So write this all the way there. So what would this mean? Let's put the constant in front first. And then at this part, you realize these two cancel, simplify, times, put in the denominator. All these things happen, right?
Yes.
So let's see. We can use one of the x to times it here, right?
Yes.
First, let me write it. What happens? So use one x. Here's still 1 over x, right?
Yes.
And then here becomes a half, so half we can just take it in front. Then this will become a 1/4.
Okay.
So these two come together. Then it's this part, these two simplify. So x squared will make this an x cubed. Then there's a negative. So it makes this a negative, right?
Yes.
Then at this part, you still have this, the square root.
Yep.
And it's like this. Am I right?
Okay.
So at this part, pi over 8 plus 1 over 6 minus... Okay, so we can use 1x, put it inside, right?
Yes.
Then next, what we can have? Well, after we put one of that inside, we can use the completing square, right?
Yes.
So it will become like this.
Okay.
Then at this part, you realize we can't straight away solve it. So what do we do? You know what? You know what? You know what we can't straight away solve?
Because
that in this part, what should you put in? You don't have to use integral by parts. Because that will become too hard, right?
Yeah.
Plus, you already used before integral by parts. But in where? Which step do we use it? Guess the step.
I mean...
You say, yes, correct. Here, we used it, right?
Yeah.
Correct. Okay, so right now I heard that you said we'll use substitution, right?
Yes.
So let's just use substitution.
Okay.
So we'll need to let. But let what? Do you know what to let?
So... what?
X minus 1, what do you want it to be? Sine.
Sine, okay.
So, that will mean here is an x equals sine theta plus 1. And then after that, what happens? You need to find dx. Yeah. What is it, right?
Okay.
So from here, what is dx? That's cosine theta d theta, right?
Yes.
And then, what do we have? You know what?
What?
So then for this part, find the range for theta.
Okay.
So the range for theta, that means it will go from 0 all the way to?
0 all the way to half pi.
Yes, correct. Half
and
pi.
Why do you need to color that? I mean, write it like that.
So like this. Is it all right?
Okay.
So for this part, pi over 8 is still here. 1 over 6 is still here.
Okay.
Now what?
Now like the last term.
So last term, it appears to be quite hard.
Yes, but at last the answer is still quite simple.
So 0 all the way to half pi.
Pi.
Then here you have 1. No, I'm just gonna write d theta.
Okay.
And in front of that you can have this part, cosine theta. So when you sub in front, x squared is still there. X squared. Then the other part, that is the cosine theta. So at this part, pi over 8 plus 1 over 6. Then what next? Do you know about that? So here, when you minus, so these two parts will cancel, right?
Yes.
So, okay. Now I got it. You know what happened?
So we just change to the from the cosine.
So a numerator and denominator times something, right?
Yes.
Then this is equal to the pi over 8. Plus 1 over 6 and then minus. So at this part, here's the hard thing. Now what? So 1 is equal to the sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta. Why can't use that? So we have two of the sine squares. One of the cosine square.
Okay.
And also one of the minus 2 sine theta. So here it is over. So cosine to the power of 4 theta.
Okay.
Then you had at last that d theta, right? Am I right?
Yep.
So next I'll move here. So this would be equal to the pi over 8 plus 1 over 6 minus 1/4. So we can separate that.
Okay.
Now here, 2 sine squared theta over the cosine to the power of 4 theta. Well, that is easy. So do you know why is it easy? If you want to know why is it easy, focus.
Okay.
So here we have 2.
Why is it smaller? Because that there won't be enough space.
Tangent theta.
Is it? Yes, but can you just write it smaller?
You mean tangent square.
Again? If you just write it smaller, there won't be much space left.
So next we have a cosine square theta. So cosine is 4 over cosine to the power of 4. That means at the denominator is a cosine square. Right? Then after that you need to minus 2 sine theta. Over the cosine to the power of 4 theta, then is d theta. So at this point, we can start integrating. Okay, so we integrate. So from here you can have 2 over 3 tangent cube theta. Then here is a tangent plus a tangent theta. Then minus, so here that comes from the 2 over 3 cosine cube theta. So here we need a plus. Am I right?
Yes.
So this will be equal to the pi over 8 plus 1 over 6 minus. So now at this part, we can common denominator. That is the 3 cosine cube theta. Then here 2 sine cube theta plus 3 cosine. Wait, let me just write that sine first. 3 sine theta cosine square theta. Right?
Yes.
Then plus that 2. Then you need to start from. And wait a second, why is there a d theta here? Instead of sub from 0 to half pi. And that is more like it. So now the problem comes. When you sub 0, it's gonna be an infinity.
Yes, so.
But that's totally not right, because for the last time, the method which is the polar coordinate, we don't get an infinity.
Yes,
so let's try to find. What is it actually, okay?
Yep. So here, we need to use the limit, but no differentiations.
Why? Why no differentiation?
Yeah. It just said the limit.
So for this, what do we need to use? Is it L'Hopital's rule?
Yes, but don't pronounce the L'Hopital's rule as the Hospital's rule, or the L'Hospital's rule.
this right?
Yes.
So that plus 2 is just a 0, right?
Yep, of course.
So like this, is it right? So that means at last we cancel and simplify.
Yes.
Wait a second. It's when you start half pi, not when you start zero. There, that's much better. So at this part, now what happens? So that means you'll have limit theta approaches to half pi. Then you have cosine theta over 3 sine theta, and it's also a negative. So at last, when you sub them in, it just becomes a 0. So we don't need to care about that part simply.
Okay.
Right?
Yes.
So that means we have pi over 8 plus 1 over 6 minus. So how far we don't care. What we have is, so at first it's a negative. Then behind here, when you start in 0, 2 over 3. And wait a second, this doesn't seem right. Wait, so we'll need to check for any mistakes. Because there's a sign here, there's something weird about this.
The second is a positive.
Where? Which part?
Positive 2 over 3.
Wait, but this is a minus whatever 0 sub in. Wait, so let me see whether it's there.
Minus 2 cosine. Wait, minus 2 over cosine. Oh, this is a minus. So that means.
Wait, why? Because when you integrate, you have an actual negative from here.
And then after it becomes a positive, the sine becomes a cosine, becomes a negative.
Oh, so you say that there are two negatives?
Yeah.
No wonder. You were right. Now that's much more like it. So the answer you get should be a pi over 8. Is that right?
Yeah.
The same answer is also pi over 8. So this time it is all right. So you see from this complicated word.
So if you use the right method, it will be correct. If you get them wrong, you will get a mismatch, which means that this part, the answer won't be correct. But if the answer is correct at last, but then and the middle steps are wrong, it's just a lucky try.
Okay, so in this time, are you clear so far?
Yes, and you also need to think about the graph.
The What is it? What other names can we give for this graph?
It's
the integral
region.
Yes, correct. So in this lesson, can we end here?
Yep.
Okay, so do you have anything else to say or anything else to ask?
Nope.
So if you like our videos, don't forget to subscribe to our channel.
Okay, hope you like our videos.
See you in the next lesson. Thank you for your watching.